Hi, everybody. Welcome to Clan Chat, and this is an Elite Series special. Joining myself and Kevin are four guys who will be involved in the Elite Series, who played for the Clan last season, of course. If you look in the top left of your screen, it's Craig Peacock, now with Manchester Storm. Bottom left-hand corner, Matt Haywood of Manchester Storm. Underneath me on the screen, Jack Musil with Sheffield Steelers. And bottom right-hand corner, it is Jack. It's not Jack at all. It's Liam, Liam Stenton, who's off to Nottingham Panthers. Guys, great to have you on board. Kevin, great to see you as well. That bar looking more and more stocked the more we see it. How are you doing?
Yeah, I'm doing great, thanks. Good to see you, Craig. Good to see you guys.
Excellent. Right, well, guys, of course, the Elite Series is coming up in just over a week's time. You can watch all the games being streamed live. Information is throughout the Elite League channels. But we'll start with the Manchester Storm guys, Craig and Matt, of course. We had the draft a couple of weeks ago now. As we look back, how exciting was it to be involved in something like that, knowing there was a chance your name would be picked out? We'll start with you, Craig.
Yeah, I mean, it's different. It was something British guys have never really experienced before. You know, we don't go through that in our junior lives. I didn't expect to go through a draft at 32 years old, but here we are. So you're just happy to be picked, aren't you, really, I guess.
Woody, same for you as well. You and I spoke for a piece I did on British ice hockey about the whole experience as well. But are you looking forward to it now that the tournament itself is coming close?
Yeah, I'm getting obviously getting excited to play again. It's been over a year since we've skated, really. So this first two or three sessions before the game is going to be quite interesting and take a bit of oxygen down with us, see if we can get through it.
Of course, other two guys with us, Jack Musil, you're part of it, the Sheffield Steelers team. We're seeing all these names getting picked up just now. A lot of players coming from the Norwegian League as well. How excited are you for the whole thing? It's going to be nice to just to hit the ice again and get going.
Yeah, it's been a while, really. You know, with year of lockdown, so it's just nice to get back on the ice, and it'll be good for all of us just to play some games and compete with each other, and it'll be good.
And what have
Jack,
you got
for yourself? Sorry, Jack. I was just going to say for yourself. For most of the guys, they've been out for 1 year. You practically missed most of the season before that as well. So it must be getting on for 2 years since you were really playing in a meaningful way.
I think it was my last game was January. So yeah, it's been a while, but I feel good. So I feel better than I have at any point of last season. So I think I'm excited to get on the ice and get going.
And Liam, of course, welcome to Clan Chat. You, of course, made 10 appearances for the Clan last year, part of your two-way deal with the Solway Sharks. How exciting is it to get an opportunity with a club like the Nottingham Panthers and the players that they've attracted so far?
It's really good. I wasn't expecting, I thought, to get picked. Honestly, I just thought I'll throw my name in there and hopefully something happened. But they picked me up and I'm buzzing to go. I can't wait. It's been over a year since I've been on ice as well, so really excited.
Of course, Liam, you would have had some words of encouragement from Martin Grubb, your coach at Solway as well. What's he said about the whole thing?
Yeah, he's really happy. He's really glad I'm getting a chance, and he's hoping I'm going to smash it. So I hope I'll do him proud.
Now, of course, the tournament itself was kind of announced about 3-4 weeks ago now. It was more or less come out of the blue. What was your reaction to the news that a tournament was going to be played, given we have now gone so long without any top flight hockey action? Anyone at all?
Who wants it?
Best get in some shape.
I that was probably everyone's first reaction as well. I wish I had a bit longer to prepare for it. But no, I think, when they cancelled our season and then the whole year was kind of every few months, it was, there was a bit of hope that something might happen. I think I don't know how the other guys felt, but I'd got to a point where I was, okay, we're probably not going to play any hockey this season. So when it kind of started hearing the murmurs of this one, I wasn't, all in on it because it hadn't happened and materialized a few times before. So when it just kind of came about, it's obviously very exciting for us to all get back on the ice. But yeah, it was a year of kind of disappointment of hoping things would happen. So it's nice that, I mean, we're doing it in April, but it's nice to have something.
And of course, we'll talk about you for a second, Pete, because obviously you've got the Elite Series coming up. immediately after that, the World Championship. And from all the information we've seen, it is geared to help the guys with a chance at getting involved with the GB squad. I take it that's something you're very keen to be involved with, the World Championships in Latvia in May.
Yeah, I mean, I guess every British player would be keen to be involved in that. It's been a couple of years out the team for me. Unfortunate with an injury the last time when they first went away. It's something I would like to break back into. And I think, you know, the amount of British guys that are playing in this tournament, it gives everyone kind of a fair whack at it. And if you can do well in the 5 weeks, then you never know.
Now, Woody, you're going down there. Ben Davis is there. Zach Sullivan's there. Peaks is going to be joining you. Ryan Finnerty's going to be there. Have you had a word with Matt Keith and Stefan Meyer? See if they're up for coming back.
Jonesy's going to be the backup, I think. I think that's the best thing about that team we've got is we've got obviously guys who've played together here, but we've also we know people like Kieran Long and Josh Batch as well. We've played with them growing up for England's GBs, whatever. So it would be good to catch up with those guys and meet some new people that we've only just played against. You don't really get to know people you just played against, so it'll be nice to see what they're really like off the ice, and hopefully we can have some fun and win some games.
Matt, can I just ask on the COVID front, you know, how are you guys being managed in the tournament in terms of COVID protocols? Like, who are you allowed to mix with, and you know, what kind of protection will there be around you?
What I've gathered up, we've got that much information. I think we're having a big induction day on the Monday. Peaks, am I right there? I think what it is what I kind of got is we've each got our own floor in the hotels sort of thing. So only Manchester will be on floor 2 with physio rooms in there. And then we'll have our own conference room where we can kind of get together, or we have food, like our breakfast, lunch, dinner in that room. So I don't think there'll be a lot of mingling. Obviously, no mingling between teams and stuff. Tested, I don't know if it's every day or every 2 days. The lateral flow ones that come back instantly or whatever. So I don't know the protocols if somebody tests positive or anything. I think we have to wait until the Monday. Sorry, man. I nearly fell over there.
It's going to be great fun to see competitive ice hockey again. Jack, back to you with the Sheffield Steelers. I mean, they always go big in these kind of things. You'll have seen the signings that they've made as well. What have you made of the players that Aaron Fox has brought in coming into your team?
I mean, to be honest, I don't really know much about. I mean, obviously the British guys, you know, you've played against them and you've heard about them, so you know they're all good players. But other like the imports, I'm not that familiar with any of them. But yeah, it'd be good to just, you know, play on the team and just you know compete, as I said earlier, and you know, have some fun and work hard, and it'll be a good blast for all of us. And yeah, I'm excited for it.
I mean, Kevin was asking the guys there about information from Manchester about, you know, leading up to the tournament. Have you had anything from Sheffield regarding yourself and what you have to do and what's expected?
As Woody was saying, there's not been a whole lot of information, but I believe that we'll be practicing in Sheffield and then kind of commuting as a team. That's what I've kind of got from it. I believe I'll be commuting down to Sheffield because I'll be staying at my house in Hull with Dave Phillips, because he lives, right near where I live. So I believe we'll be commuting to Sheffield and then on to Nottingham for games.
A car share, buddy. Nice.
Yeah.
And of course, Liam, being part of the Nottingham team, you know, there's a lot of big names in that team and guys that you'll have seen from afar. How exciting, how surreal even is it going to be linking up with these guys next week when you all get together and start practicing?
It's going to be great. It's going to be different. Obviously, I'm used to coming to the Clanty train, and I know everybody in that team last year, and even coming up to there was quite surreal for me. So going down there and being with that team for 5 weeks straight, it's going to be really surreal, and I'm really looking forward to it.
Now, has there been any... Sorry, Kev.
I was just going to ask from a fitness point of view, guys, you know, obviously it's been a while since anybody played, and you know, even if you've been quite diligent at staying fit, there's probably quite a difference between being fit and being ice fit. How concerned are you about fitness levels going into this one, particularly when teams are now picking up guys that are coming into the squads off the back of, you know, 36 game campaigns in Denmark and Norway and places like that? Is fitness going to be a big issue for you guys?
Well, I'm 19, so... well, I think it will be for a lot of people, including myself. I've been biking, so... But nothing, I feel like nothing ever gets you ice fit. Like, nothing apart from being on the ice can get you ice fit. So it's just really the first couple of training sessions I've got to get us back in that, hopefully.
Yeah, I think going on from that, you probably just like a bit rusty as well, you know, on getting touches on the puck and, you know, just things that you usually take for granted, like making passes and receiving passes, you know, that might take a couple of days to get back, but I wouldn't say it'll be too much of an issue for any of us. I'm sure we've all been, you know, we're all prepared.
I think the key is to not be the worst guy. You can be the second worst guy as long as you're not the worst guy.
Just look busy.
Absolutely. And it has been tough. I mean, how have you kept in shape over the last year? You know, the fact that you probably haven't been near an ice rink, or if you have, it's been very limited. What have you done by way of any ice work, if possible?
There's not really much you can do other than go for a run or a home workout or something like that. But in Scotland, obviously now the outdoor gyms are kind of open, so we've been able to do that for the last couple of weeks, which has helped. But yeah, I mean, other than that, you've just got to try and eat healthy and, you know, do what you can with what you got, which isn't much. I mean, I hate running with a passion, so I haven't done much of that. But yeah, what can you do? The gyms are open for a little bit. I think I managed to get there for a few weeks until it shut down again, and then you're just on and off. So.
And show everybody what you did beforehand when I asked you about fitness before we started. What was it you done?
I showed you my belly, didn't I?
The guns.
Yeah, Your turn, Craig.
nobody needs to see that, I can assure you. Nobody needs to see that. But of course, this tournament has been played behind closed doors. All the games are at the Motor Point Arena in Nottingham. How weird is it going to be playing without a crowd? We've seen it in the tournaments in the NIHL so far, but you guys are used to having a big crowd around you, lots of noise. It's going to be surreal, isn't it?
Yeah, I think it's going to be really weird. I think we'll get used to it pretty quick, but it'll be kind of like a scrimmage in a practice session. But I think the whole excitement of playing again will kind of get us through the first few weeks. But then I think towards the end, we'll really start to miss the fans and stuff, and it's great that it's been streamed. And I think if it's the same company that's doing the NIHL one, then it's a really good stream. And I know they're having interviews and stuff in between periods, so it should be good. It should be good to watch, and hopefully it can put on some entertaining hockey for everybody.
My name's John Strange. I'm the managing director here at Asprey Glasgow West, proud sponsors of the Glasgow Clan for the past couple of years, and very excited to be the title sponsor for this coming year. So Asprey, what do? Well, Asprey help people make successful buildings insurance claims. So that's anything from fire, flood, escape of water, burst pipes, criminal damage, malicious damage, any kind of damage that your building suffers and you think, I'm going to have to make an insurance claim on this, then get in touch with us right away for help and advice. We manage the claim from the very, very start to the very, very end. And the good news for you, the homeowner, is that if we manage the claim from start to finish, there's absolutely no charge to you for our service. Obviously, we are very passionate about supporting the clan here at Asprey Glasgow West, but we want to also be able to support the fans. So when you call us, please make sure you mention Glasgow Clan, and we'll give you a £100 voucher towards your policy excess payment. I hope to see everyone again very, very soon at the hockey. Take care and stay safe.
I've seen Guy Doucet at Nottingham Panthers, for example, he's been talking about how this tournament, certainly from the Panthers' point of view, is seen as a short window, I think, for a lot of players. And I suppose it's the game, same for you guys as well. You're going to be out there playing, so there's a chance you might get spotted. I'm not wanting to see you guys leave the clan, of course, but, you know, as a possibility, I guess.
I think it's really good for the young Brits, like Stents and people like that. And I know Kieran Brown just left, but like shooters, Cole Shooter, and people like that who might not really have been on the GB map, but then Pete sees them playing against these top guys and they're obviously doing well. Like Stents is going to go down and do really well because he just needs the chance to do it because he's definitely capable of doing it. But I think for GB international wise, it's really good for the young Brits. I think they're going to be they'll surprise quite a few people.
Now the tournament itself starts.
No, I was just following on from what Matt's saying there. You know, there's a few names in the rosters that stand out to me as guys that we've probably never even seen in Elite League. So, you know, even taking the GB thing out of it, I think, you know, it's a real good opportunity for young British players to showcase themselves for a place in teams in the Elite League. So, you know, for all the things that we've lost over the past year through the COVID shutdown, this might be a real kind of shining light for a lot of young British talent to get a chance to show what they can do.
It's a perfect opportunity for those guys. I mean, when I came into the league a long time ago, there was only 10 imports. So Brits tended to get, you know, more of an opportunity. But for guys like Stents and Moose, when they've come into the league, it's 13, 14 imports however many years, and it's obviously a results-based business. So young Brits aren't getting the chance. So this, with only 8 imports on a team, you know, all these guys are going to get that opportunity to prove themselves. And like you say, guys who haven't been around Elite League teams are coming into this and playing as well. And that's only a good thing for British hockey. And I think they're all going to come up and show that they're capable of playing. And yeah, it puts them in the shop window for, you know, the other 6 teams that aren't playing as well. And hopefully some of these young guys will be able to get some spots on some teams, you know, when the normal season resumes.
When a normal season does resume, sorry, Craig, I think you'll find that the import numbers might go down from 14. I know they're supposed to go down one this year, but the quality won't be much worse if you go down one or two more, do you know what I mean? So I think people will realise that it's going to be good for British development as well.
Well, that's just what I was going to ask you. Is this going to be a game changer for the future of the league, do you think? Because we have had 13, 14 imports now for a few years. Money's going to come into it, of course, because of the pandemic and lesser costs and everything. Is this going to change the future of the league, do you think?
I think so. I think so, but I don't think by too much, because you've got to find that balance between development and also putting on a good product. Nobody wants to see your team getting beat every single weekend sort of thing. And just finding that balance, I think, isn't it? Getting a good competitive team. But if you could do that by adding one or two extra young Brits who are obviously good players and exciting to see, then why wouldn't you do that?
But even go down as far as 8 imports, for example, as this tournament is as well, I think there was talk of them going down, as Pete said, down 1 import if this was a normal season. But taking it down to maybe 10, would that be a bad thing?
Oh, it's the age-old question, isn't it? You've got to try and find what that right balance is. Obviously, the less imports there are, there's more opportunity for British players. But then, you know, it is a product at the end of the day, and it's a business, and fans pay their money and they want to see the best thing on the ice. I think the main thing this series will do will just prove that there is lots of British players out there that are capable and worthy of spots on Elite League teams, depending whatever the kind of numbers are. And it might give teams more confidence to give those guys a chance. But, you know, who knows where the import numbers are going to go. It's changed so much. Nobody knows what the right import level is. So, yeah, it's just a good opportunity for everybody.
Now, I think, Craig, there's a totally different dynamic at play here, though, because normally we have the debates about import numbers. That's a healthy debate to have at any time. But, you know, following a pandemic, what we don't know at the moment is, and what would probably be the driver in changing it, would be how many bums are we allowed on seats. you know, I think this mini series is going to be a good test for the league in terms of what's the appetite like for people to pay for streaming services. So that'll be interesting to see. But, you know, in terms of import numbers, if we could only have, for example, 50% capacity in arenas, that would be a big driver to how much budget there is to spend in teams and logically how many imports there would be. So I think, you know, that you asked the question a wee while ago, is this going to be a game changer for the league in terms of import numbers? It may be, at least short term, but that may be driven by, you know, just government decisions and guidelines and how many people we can safely have in arenas.
Yeah, you could, I guess you could say this is like kind of a good trial for something like that, you know, seeing, okay, did fans, you know, want to pay? Are they going to like the product? So, yeah, it's kind of a trial run for the league to see, you know, what the fan reaction is to eight imports and, you know, the cost of the games and all that. So I think could be a big factor in, you know, how they go going forward. Maybe no one likes it and all the fans think it's not no good, and, you know, then they go up to 18 imports, you know, so I guess time will tell.
Yep. And of course, win-win for the league. Sorry, yeah. Craig, it's a win-win for the league, I think, because if it works, great, but if it doesn't, then they kind of prove their own point, sort of thing. But I think if it does work, what you got to worry about is 4 or 5 years down the line when younger Brits come up, say the standard slightly less, then that's going to suffer the national team in the long run. I know, all of us are British, we're going to say we want lower import numbers, but they make the league a lot more competitive where they are. Like it wasn't when it was 10 imports when me and Pete's kind of came in. We had the big four, and they kind of ran away with it because they had the best Brits sort of thing. Everyone else kind of had filler Brits, but as we've seen, especially the Scottish teams, have got a lot more competitive over the 10 years that I've been playing with it in the league. And I think it actually has helped the national team. I know we take a lot of dual nationals and stuff, but I think the caliber of the British player has gone up with the higher import level. So that's an argument against it. So we've got to find that happy medium.
Now, going back to we talked about fitness and everything earlier on, and Kevin asked the question about blowing off the cobwebs and stuff. The schedule looks quite hectic. You know, the games are all coming thick and fast. How are you all going to handle the amount of games in such a short space of time?
I'm on the massage table. Go on, Sid.
Rulu's got to think of how it comes. You know, like, you don't know how, obviously, the games are going to be competitive, but they may be some games that are easier than others. Like, you just don't know. So, like, you just got to take it as it comes and hope you stay alive, really.
I'm hoping for muscle memory to kick in. Because we've all grown up playing lots of games in a day or lots of games in a weekend or whatever. So hopefully it's still in there somewhere. You got to have muscles to have muscle memory, though. That's the only thing.
Stuff. And for you guys, obviously you're all playing for your different teams. Is there a name on the roster, or names maybe, that you're going to be part of? Any players in there that you're excited to be working with, players that you're looking forward to working with? Who stands out for you guys? Peaks, we'll start with you.
I mean, no names in particular. I think Manchester had some good, exciting players that they've kind of brought back. They've still got few announcements to make in terms of imports. I'd probably expect some guys that we haven't seen, you know, to the league. So yeah, it'd just be exciting because obviously you compete with these guys year in, year out. So to be, you know, on the same side of them is going to be interesting. No kind of one name is standing out in particular. I mean, for most of us that Finna drafted, it's a chance for us to work with him again as well, which, you know, a lot of us have done in the past, which well for our team in this tournament.
Woody?
Yeah, same. It's quite nice that we have got Finna because we kind of well know what system he wants to play, and it's just the only downside is you have to work really hard for but I think if I have to say a guy, I'm looking forward to playing with Travis' brother. It'd be nice to see the difference if he smiles or not, like Travis.
What about you, Jack? Who Steelers are you looking forward to working with?
Well, I mean, they've got a lot of like the big name British players on the Steelers, so it'll be good to play with some of those guys and just, you know, get to know them. Because I only know, as I said, Dave Phillips, but the other guys that I'm not that familiar with. So it'll be, you know, good to get into a room with them and, you know, learn a bit off of them and just play with, you know, some real good players.
Or Liam Kirk, as he's known, of course.
Yeah. Right, there's a couple, you know, big Brits in there, Dowd and Phillips.
You got the British Bulldog down there, maybe. You got
I saw that on social media. It'll be good. I'm excited.
What about you, Liam? Anybody in the Panthers roster that you're looking forward to teaming up with?
Everybody, I'm looking forward to just getting a nice, like, look, working with everybody's going to be great. New coaches, new teammates. It's just got to be different, but I'm looking forward to that.
There's always one cop out, isn't there? Just give it an answer, man. Goodness sake. It's going to be a great tournament, of course. We're all looking forward to it. So the Clan fans watching, obviously interested to hear your thoughts on the tournament ahead. I'm going to put you in the spot a little bit. I'm going to ask you why Clan fans should be supporting your team through the Elite Series, if they can bring themselves to, of course. Beaks and Woody, flying the flag for Manchester Storm. Why should the Clan fans be supporting you guys?
Manchester Storm, isn't it?
Simple as that.
There's always been a connection. It's simple.
There has. Jack, Steelers, fly the flag.
That is a very tough question.
They won't get kicked out of the stands for making too much noise in this. In this
I don't know. Because we're the best team.
Oh, that's trash talk. That's trash talk.
I don't know.
Right, Liam, for the Panthers, go.
We've got one, haven't we? Just got to support a winning team.
There we go. I'm convinced. I'm convinced by all of them. And of course, some good Coventry Blaze as well that make up the foursome as well. First of all, your last thoughts, guys, as we come towards the end of this edition of Clan Chat, the fitness we've covered, the fixtures and everything else. What do you hope to get out of this short series over the 5 weeks, other than the chance to hopefully win something? How good will it do you for, presumably, we hope, will be a full season starting again in September?
I think it's going to be great. Like, obviously, it's going to be good to get your fitness back, blah, blah, blah. But I think it's going to be good for mental health, really. I think I speak for everyone where we say we've really struggled and not been able to go out and do stuff and play hockey, and fans as well haven't been able to watch hockey. So I think it's going to be good all around for everybody just to see how the league can do it. And hopefully we can transfer it into a season next year, which should be good. And then towards the end of the season, get the fans back in or whatever the plans are.
There you go. Yeah, I mean, same kind of answer from me. Just, you know, a whole year of this corona, and it's going to be like being little kids again, you know, getting back to the rink. It's always, you get a little excited when you're at the rink with the boys and playing hockey. It's always a good time, and you know, it'll be a blast to, you know, play some hockey again.
Liam?
I think it'll be good to just get back to playing hockey. Like, it's been a year of unknowing, and just getting something that we can actually look forward to and get going on. It's going to be good to have something to do for 5 weeks straight instead of being told we can and can't do this. And, you know, it'll be good to get back into routine as well and get going again, and hopefully next season starts up normal and we get going again.
There we go. I think that sums it up nicely, guys. Thank you so much for that. We'll just wrap up everything now by telling you about the Clan Classics game this Saturday. I think it's the last one in the series. I think we're taking a short break after this one. It's the Clan against the Manchester Storm. That's at 7 o'clock on Saturday on the Clan YouTube channel. Shirts off the back. It's the season one clone jerseys. I recommend them, having won one myself at the weekend. It's Matt Haywood, Adam Walkers and John Landry's that are up for grabs this week. It's £1 a ticket. Don't forget the equipment raffle is on there as well. Check out the Clan social media for all the information on that. 50-50. The draw takes place at the end of the month. That'll be Monday, and it's a bumper cash prize, so make sure you get your tickets for that as well. In the meantime, let's wish these guys all the best. Craig Peacock, Matt Haywood, all the best at Manchester Storm.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Jack, all the best at Sheffield Steelers.
Thank you very much.
And Liam, best of luck to you at Nottingham Panthers as well.
That's great. Thank you.
Excellent. And Kevin, thanks for joining us. As always, pleasure to see you. Keep those drinks coming.
Best of luck to the guys.
Thank you.
Excellent. And that's it from this edition of Clan Chat, the Elite Series special featuring these four guys here. We'll certainly keep tabs on your progress while the tournament's going on. In the meantime, thank you so much for watching Clan Chat. Good to see you as always. And we'll be back with another one soon. Take care. Bye for now.